My name is Nicolaas Fourie. I'm a research fellow at NIH, and we are in building 10 in room 2N104. It's one of the laboratories of the National Institute of Nursing Research. We study gastrointestinal diseases or disorders, mainly the ones that we don't really know what causes them, what the underlying causes of those are. So typically things like IBS. And we also work with many patients which are undiagnosed, but they have gastrointestinal symptoms. Originally from Cape Town, South Africa, or a town just outside of Cape Town. I suppose I was just always fascinated by animals and plants since I can remember. I think since anyone that knows me can remember. And it just grew naturally from that. A lot of our research involves trying to look at the molecular underpinnings of these disorders and diseases. So in other words, we look at the DNA and RNA, which is the product of DNA. So it's the genes that are being transcribed. So we get patient samples in from the clinic, which is either blood or tissue samples, or sometimes saliva, urine, stool, all kinds of different samples. And then we process them here in this lab. We use a lot of centrifuges to spin the samples down. So depending on how hard you spin them down, different kinds of cells and material in your sample will separate from one another, which really saves us a lot of time. Some of these things can take a long time to do, hours and hours. And with this machine, we can do a large batch of samples in under 2 hours. We use a lot of different kits. A lot of these processes now, you can buy pre-made kits that have all the supplies in that you need to do your extractions. Over the short term, we're making advances in understanding what the molecular underpinnings of some of these disorders are, these gastrointestinal disorders are. And this will help us in the long term to design either interventions or treatments for these conditions. It helps us to identify the things we need to treat or targets in your biology that we can attack to try and relieve some of these symptoms. Five, 10, 15 years from now, I think that we're going to be at a stage, and we're already getting there, that people are already starting to do this, but where we can intervene in specific molecular pathways, specific biological processes, by modifying or the specific components of those processes. And that's really, I think, where a lot of the future of medicine lies. Also, because we're doing these kinds of molecular studies, we can really personalize diagnostics, we can personalize treatment. So if you just pursue your whatever interests you, whatever fascinates you in the moment, that will lead you to other things, and you can grow much better that way, I think, than trying to put yourself in too narrow a box too early on. And that's one of the things that NIH allowed me to do. I came from an evolutionary biology background, and I was able to transfer some of those understandings and skills to something very, very different, while at the same time learning how to do a lot of the molecular biology and the sort of translational clinical research that we're doing now. Thank you.